So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to go on top of this with my knees and balance and not fall off. Okay, Mabuhay Squad? Wish me luck. Here goes nothing.
Hey guys, welcome to my daily vlogs. Please subscribe.
All right, here we go. Whoa, gotta stabilize. Stabilize. And then when you're stabilized, gotta try to get up. Not on my feet. I used to be able to do it on my feet, but I need like the help of like a bar or a wall. I'll just try my knees. No rush. There we go. Whoa. Got it. Woohoo! All right. I know that seems like nothing, guys, but trust me, it could be dangerous. I'll be able to do it on my feet someday soon. Good morning, Mabuhay Squad. How are you all doing? OMG. So, this morning, I woke up early, went for my walk, and OMG, there's a storm blowing through the Philippines right now. I got caught in the rain. Oh, it was awesome. It was so refreshing. I had to like seek shelter underneath like this roof at like a strip mall or something like that. But oh, it was so refreshing. I'm glad I still got my walk in, and we're now having breakfast with the dogs.
Good morning, Sahara.
Good morning.
She's barking because she sees a dog all the way down there. Cypher 2.
Cypher, is that a dog?
Is that a dog?
Yes, good morning, Cypher.
It's okay, Cypher. And Rizal over there too. Rizal is so well behaved. Even if there are other dogs there, he will not bark. He's just chill, just hangs out. Beautiful flower arrangement, as usual, here at Sonia's garden. Always fresh flowers. Beautiful, beautiful white linens. Infused Kanjan water. And always fresh juice. What is this one?
Mango.
Let's taste.
Mango?
Mm-hmm.
Definitely mango. Let's try this. Kanjan water, guys.
Infused with lemon. Looks like mint leaves. Cucumber, carrots, and
not sure, a lemon.
Cypher's barking.
Guys, they see a cat.
I don't see no cat. Where's the cat? Is that a cat? It's okay, cats are our friends. Cats are our friends, Sahara.
I wonder what would happen if we ever got a kitten.
If we got a kitten, would you be nice to it, Sice? I hope so.
Guys, I'm taking mushrooms and zucchini, putting it in pandesal. It's like a bun. These fresh Filipino bread buns. And putting it in, oh my gosh, so good. Delicious. Want some? Here. Is it good?
I love living in the Philippines because
fresh mango. Let's eat.
I think Rizal wants some.
Rizal, you want mangoes? Or do you have to pee?
Rizal was so good this morning. He peed and pooed outside. He's got it down master now. He wakes up, goes outside, pees on the puppy pad they put outside, poos as well.
Whoa, it is raining. So guys, I think the storm is full blast now. Whoa, passing through. Look at that. It looks like we're at the bottom of a waterfall. Seriously. Like, you know what I mean? Like we're behind a waterfall. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Powerful tropical storms, I tell you.
All right, guys, let's see our positive affirmation for Tuesday, October the 12th. My garden of affirmations is blossoming. Ooh, I love that. Love it. My garden of affirmations is blossoming. Ooh, a garden. All right, let's see if Jabba the Hutt will eat. Come on, Jabs. I know you already ate this week, but will you eat again? Nope. Come on. No? Not hungry? Okay. No problem. I'll try again another day. This frog is just unpredictable. Like, he'll eat. Sometimes he's hungry, sometimes he's not. I waste a pellet if he's not. But, I mean, that's just the way it's been with this frog for years now. But he's still fat, still colorful, and still healthy, which is great. See you later, Jabba the Hutt.
Oh, looks like the rain stopped, guys. All right, that's good. It just might start up again. That's just the way the weather's been.
All right, guys. So, if you watch the Ants Canada channel, you'll know that I've got a bunch of queens in here, along with lots of workers. These ants have been super prolific. So they're just welcoming their first generation of workers. Look, I'll show you.
See them? Each one of these, in each one, there's a large ant, that's the queen, and those are her babies. You see? Now, I've just been feeding them once a week, and now they're due for another meal, and I gotta feed them.
And for their meal, it's just this little thing of jelly. I take a toothpick, I scoop up a little bit of the jelly, and then I place a tiny, like, blob inside each test tube. If you guys saw last week's episode at Ants Canada, you guys saw how cute the ants are. When they eat, it's just adorable, and they love this jelly. So I've gotta be very careful though. Like, gotta make sure they don't escape. Right now there are only a few workers in each test tube, so I can manage to do it without ants escaping, but soon I'll need to create an outworld for these guys. Like, basically a tank where the ants can, like, go into and search for their own food instead of me having to put the food inside the test tube, make it so hard for myself. Okay, seriously, they're, like, ready to escape. This is epic. I have an idea, guys, an epic idea for this week's episode. I can't wait to start filming it. All right, in goes the jelly, and yeah! On goes the cotton swab. Go eat. Look at them eating. See them eating the jelly there? Aren't they so cute? Yes. And see there, those are the eggs, like the brood and upcoming workers. See? Ah, that's gonna be enough food for them for the whole week. But I have another meal planned for them, yes! For this week. It's gonna be awesome. Okay, colony number two. Now, I don't know what I'm gonna do with all of these colonies, guys. Like, do I keep them all? I was thinking, let some go. Here you go. There's a blob of jelly, guys. My heart is so full watching these ants eat. I love feeding ants. Do you guys feed ants? Or do you step on ants? Don't worry, tell the truth. I won't be offended. I'll just block you. Just kidding. I mean, there are more where they came from, so I don't take it personally. And, like, ants are not endangered, so people are always like, I have an ant problem. What do I do? And, like, to be honest, if you really, really want to get rid of them, a pest company, seriously. But there are ways to make them not want to stay in your house. You basically need to make it hard for them to live there. And I actually have a video of that on my ant channel, Ants Canada. Look it up. How to deal with pest ants. I have some tips there. Like, for example, use spray vinegar on their trails and wipe and keep destroying their trails, because ants leave like a scent trail where they forage. It's basically like a Google Maps for ants. It helps them know where the food is. So if you, like, use a vinegar mixture to, like, destroy their chemical trails, you'll confuse them and they won't, like, want to stay. So tricks like that. And also, of course, being super clean. Look, aww, even the queen's feeding there. Yes. Feast ants, you deserve it. These ants have been through so much. These queens actually didn't eat a full meal till, like, the 60th day. They've just been held inside these test tubes, which is what they do in the wild. They, like, seal themselves off in what's called a claustral cell, and they don't eat. They just metabolize their body tissues, and that's what they feed the ants too. Anyways, that's all in the ant videos, you guys know. Sorry for those of you who are not interested in ants. This is an ant lesson. Oh my gosh, it's getting harder and harder to scoop this gel. Okay, here we go. Here you go, ants. I got the perfect meal for ya. There. Yes. Feast, my beloved ants. Can you imagine these things only need food once a week for, like, the next few months? Very, efficient. Okay, I'm not gonna feed this ant because it doesn't have workers yet, and I already fed it last week. In fact, that queen might not be fertilized. We'll see. Okay, this is ant colony number 6, one of my favorites. Imagine naming every ant. Hey, Paul. Hey, Peter. How's it going, Mary Lou? Oh, you're looking mighty fine, Jane. Okay, whoa. That ant almost escaped. Look at how cute they are when they discover the jelly. It's like, hey guys, something just got plopped in to the living room area. See? All right, 2 more colonies. Let's go, let's go. So this here's just sweet jelly. In the Philippines, they call it Jelly Ace. But this one in particular is not Jelly Ace. This is like an insect gel. It's got some vitamins and like minerals and stuff for the insects. It's good. But I could feed anything really, especially insects. These ants will eat anything, as you guys know who have an ant problem. Guys, do you know that there are 17,000 species? And they're discovering new ones like pretty much every week. In fact, there's an ant, guys, that we filmed at the Mabuhay Squad farmhouse. The genus is Chromatogaster. And guys, it might be a brand new species. My myrmecologist friend, Filipino, David General, who names ants, he said he has to like check because it's a species of ant that isn't known to be living in the Philippines. So I'm like, okay. So he's got to check like his ant like records of like ants in like all over Southeast Asia, like Borneo and all of that, to see if it really is a new species. Mabuhay Squad, can you imagine if we discovered a new species of ant? So for those of you who watch the Ants Canada channel, I'll show you this ant. It's right here. So here's a queen of that new species of ant, and she has some eggs and she has a few babies. So this right here might be a species that we discovered. Isn't that crazy? We should call it Chromatogaster Mabuhay Squaddy. But I'm gonna raise a colony of it because I'm like, hey, discovered a new ant species. That's awesome. All right, so all the colonies are now fed. Oh wait, I forgot to feed the new ant species. How dare I? Can you imagine? Gosh, when I first started ant keeping, I never dreamed that I might discover a new species. And this year, we actually already made some scientific discoveries that ants that we never thought were in the Philippines are actually in the Philippines. We discovered that at the Mabuhay Squad farmhouse. Ants that we never knew were on this island of Luzon, a species of Dilobocondyla is the genus. They never knew it existed in Luzon until this year, and Ants Canada filmed that. Wow, see, science is so exciting. Ants are so diverse. All right, so I've just completely rambled on and on about ants. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the Ants Canada channel if you haven't yet. Guys, my farmer's tan is getting intense. Look at that. It looks like I'm wearing a bra. So funny. And the thing is, unlike abroad, I can't walk around without a shirt. Although sometimes people do, but like they're near their house. Here you could, RG says they'll call the cops on you if you walk outside shirtless. It's considered indecent. So I can't do that. So no uneven tan. I just have to wait till we get to a beach, which will come at the end of the month. Yay, guys, we're going to Cebu. Can't wait. And I hear there's gonna be some beach time. So, ooh, I've missed a beach. We live in an island nation, and it's been like a long time since I've been to a beach. But yay, super excited about that. And all you Cebuanos represent, yes. We're going there because we're attending an event called BICON, and I'm one of the hosts. So it's gonna be live streamed, and I can't wait. It's gonna be a cool reunion too with some other creators who are friends of mine here in the Philippines, and it should be fun. I can't wait to eat the food in Cebu. Mm. And guys, I'm sure the hotel is awesome. I miss traveling. Yay! Oh my gosh, Mabuhay Squad! Something just came in the mail. We've been waiting for this for like, it seems like over a month. Weeks, 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 weeks. And it's finally arrived. Mabuhay Squad. This is a product that I highly, highly recommend. Hashtag not sponsored. And I love it. We've been using it since last year, since the lockdown during quarantine. That's where we discovered this stuff. And I think you guys will love it. Mabuhay Squad. It's this.